Hello everyone. It's correctly said, everything is theoretically impossible until it is done. The science of today is the technology of tomorrow. Today in this video, I am going to show you the relationship between the current, voltage and resistance using Ohm's law with Tinkercad. Ohm's law was discovered by George Simon Ohm. Ohm's principal discovery was that the amount of electric current through a metal conductor in a circuit is directly proportional to the voltage impressed across it for any given temperature. Algebraically, we can write as V is equal to IR, where V is the voltage and I is the current and R is the resistance. So let's start. First, open your Tinkercad site and you can log in with your own account and then click over your circuits. And then let's start by clicking create new circuits. So now, after clicking here, create new circuits, we are here in this window. Okay, so here we have all the components, and I'll choose from basic to all so that I can select whichever components I need from these all components. And now, to study the Ohm's law, we need resistors and we also need power supply. So let's bring the resistors and power supply on the main board. So here we have a resistor, and then your component name is given, and then how many resistor I have taken, one. So the resistance value is also given. The value is 1 kilo ohm. So now next, let's even search for power supply from here. Power supply. Okay, here we have our power supply. So here, this, let's bring this power supply also over here. Now this power supply is basically of 30 volt and 2 ampere, which is available here. But here I'm taking only 5 volt and then 5 ampere power supply. We can increase and decrease the range as we need. So let's connect the components now. Okay. So let's connect this. This one is the positive one and positive terminal. Then I'm connecting this to this resistor. Okay, this terminal. And this another one is negative terminal. Connecting this to this terminal. Now in resistor, we don't have polarity as there is no negative and positive terminals. Now in this, this resistor is of 1 kilo ohm. We can also increase and decrease the value of this resistance. So in this 1 kilo ohm resistor, is connected across the 5 volt power supply as per the Ohm's law. Now V is equal to IR, so current I is equal to VR. So we have voltage is 5 volt and resistance is 1 ohm. So what must be the value of current? It should be 5 ampere. So let's check by starting the simulation. Okay, so let's you can notice over here the voltage, we have 5 volt and resistance value is 1 kilo ohm, and then we are getting 5 milliampere current. So now this is done. Now let's change this a bit. We can either change voltage value of resistance, voltage value or resistance value, either of one. So first we will change the resistance value for that. Let's connect more resistance either in series or in parallel. So first I'll not connect first in series or parallel, but I'll change the resistance value from here only. I'll select this resistance. Okay, I'll increase the resistance value from 1 to 2 kilo ohm. And now let me check what happens. So as per the Ohm's law, when the resistance is when the voltage is 5 volt and the resistance is 2 kilo ohm, then your current should be 5 by 2, that is half, 2.5. So when I started, you got exactly 2.5 milliampere. So now let's change this a little and let's introduce one more resistor in series and parallel. So first let's go for a series and then I'll show you of parallel also. So let me delete this wire. Okay, you can delete this wire by clicking on the wire and then your delete button is here. And even I'll delete even this resistor also for now. Okay, now first I'll introduce the resistor, two resistors. Okay. I'll bring one more resistor. Okay, now I'll connect in. Okay, now connected in series like this. Okay, I've connected the resistor. So series, the value of each resistance resistor over here is 1 ohm. So total value is the total value of resistance is 2 ohm. So now 5 volt is connected across the 2 kilo ohm resistors. And so let's start simulation and check the result. What we are getting, we must get the same result like previous. We have taken 2 ohm resistor. So here also we will get 2.5 milliampere current. So let's check whether we are getting the same or not. Okay, yes, so we are getting the same 2.5 milliampere current. So let's remove now the wire and one resistance, and in place of that we are connecting now this was in series, we will connect in parallel. So let's remove everything, let's stop the simulation and then okay, I'll remove this also and then now I'll bring another one resistor over here. Delete even this wire also. Okay, I'm connecting these two in parallel and then after connecting these two in parallel. I'm connecting this also and now okay, I've connected this in parallel. So now when resistors are connected in parallel, that means 1 kilo ohm and 1 kilo ohm, that is 1000 ohm and 1000 ohm, the equivalent resistance is 500 ohm only. So when connected in parallel, the resistance value is going to decrease and the current value is going to increase. So now the current value we must get is 10 milliampere. And so let's check whether we are getting the same or not. So let's start simulation. Okay, so we got the same 10 milliampere. So this proves the Ohm law with Tinkercad. Enjoy yourself with fun and interesting science experiments with Tinkercad.